Hello everyone. As a part of learning programming for problem solving using C, in this session we are going to look at part 3 of your unit 3, that is enumerations and structures and unions. In this session we are going to look at these two parts, that is type definition and enumerated types. So coming to the topics, so type def in C language. So first we'll be seeing what is type def and how we are going to use type def in C language. Type def is a keyword used in C language to assign alternative names to your existing data types. So whatever data types you have learned so far, that is int, float, long, double, whatever those names, if you are feeling them as complicated or not able to understand them, you can give an alternative name to the existing particular data type. Okay, so these are mostly used for your data types whenever the names become slightly complicated to use in the programs. To make it simple for you, we can assign a particular simple name for your existing data type. So the general syntax is, you are going to write the type def keyword, a space, then whatever the existing data type name, then another space, and whatever the name you want to give for this particular existing name. So for example, so you have type def and you have an existing name called as unsigned long. So unsigned long is somewhat bigger to write your programs. So you can assign one name to this particular unsigned long, that is u long. The above statement defines a term u long for your unsigned long data type. This is how your type def can be used to assign your user names for existing data types. Okay. Now this u long can be used as unsigned long in your program until the end of your particular program. Another main advantage of using type def is when you are going to use structures. So with structures, we'll be writing a structure like this. So without type def, what you are going to write is basically you are going to create a structure with a structure name, and the structure can be having your members, member 1, member 2, member 3, and their type name. So whenever you are going to create a structure variable, you have to write a line as struct name s1. Okay, so it will be a longer thing. So to avoid a longer names to create the structure variables, we are going to use type def. When you use type def, instead of having a longer names, you can be having a shorter names. So we'll see an example. So in this particular program, you have created one structure. Just first consider, without the type def, what you are going to write the program. So you are going to write struct employee char. This employee has a name and a salary. So without type def, what you are going to write is, to create a employee 1, what you have to write, struct employee e1 or struct employee e2. So with type def, what you have done is, you have given a name emp for your particular employee structure, and with emp you can create any number of variables. Instead of writing struct employee e1, now you are writing emp e1, which is a smaller name for your particular structure. So with type def, you are going to create alternative names in this manner. The remaining part of the program is, you are taking the two inputs, that is name input and salary input for your employee 1, and you are printing these two values, that is name and salary. Let's execute this particular program. So I'm going to use the tutorial point compiler to execute this particular program. So first take an employee e1. So you have defined the structure with the type def and a emp name. So you are created one employee E1, and employee E1 you have taken the name of, you are going to take the input name and input salary. So you have to give inputs in this compiler here, standard input. So you have to give name and salary here, and if you execute this particular program, you are going to get the output as the student name is Bhuvan and the salary is 44,000. So not student name, what you have to write is employee name is, execute, employee name is Bhuvan, salary is 44,000. So similarly, you can create any number of employees E1, E2, and you can be performing the same thing, that is taking the input of your employee names and salaries. So just copy paste that one. So you have to take E2 name, employee 2 name, employee 2 salary, and you are going to print employee 2 name and employee 2 salary. So first to give the inputs, you have already given. I am giving Ravi, so I am giving 2 lakhs. So execute this thing, and you are going to get the second employee also. Employee name is Ravi and the salary is 2 lakhs. So in this manner, you can be having any number of employees in your program, and using this particular simple name EMP, or can create any number of variables in your particular program. The second thing you are going to learn as a part of this session is enumeration. Enumeration is a user defined data type in C language, where it is mainly used to assign integral constant to your names. This is printed in reverse. Here it is printed used to assign names to your integral constant, but actually you are going to assign integral constant to your names, as your numbers will be easy to understand compared to names. So how you are going to create an enumeration? First you need to know what is the use of enumeration first. So let's take an example where you are going to use days of the week in your program, and your days of the week can be having only 7 values. That is Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, up till Saturday. If you use this one, if you take this days of the week as integer data type, this integer data type can be having values from -36,000 to +36,000. But days of the week are having only 7 values. In such scenarios, you can use the enum. When you use enum, this will become a user defined data type, that is our own data type, and this data type can be having only these 7 values, Sunday to Saturday. And when I declare in this manner, you are going to create one enumeration with these, or we are going to create one data type days of the week. Just like your integer float, you are going to create one data type name as days of the week with these 7 values only, no other value. And these 7 values can be having only 7 constant numbers, that is Sunday will be having a constant number 0, Monday will be having a constant number 1, until Saturday will be having constant number 6. This is creating one own user defined data type having 7 values, and you can declare variables for this data type, that is enum, days of the week, day. Now day is one variable, days of the week is one data type. So you can assign values, that is Sunday, Monday, Wednesday. Here you are giving the value is printed as wrong. That is why, because Sunday will be given 0, Monday is given 1, Tuesday is given 2, and Wednesday is given 3. So this is day 3 actually. This is printed wrong. So in this manner, you can be creating one data type days of the week with these 7 values, and you can create variables with this data type, and you can assign values using that particular variable. And an example, So whatever you have seen in the previous one. So yes, here you are starting from Monday, not Sunday. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. So Monday will be given 0, 1, 2, 3 like this. And you are creating one variable day. And day is given the value Wednesday. So indirectly Wednesday means the value will be 0, 1, 2. So 2 will go into the day and you are going to print 2. And another example is enum year, where you are going to have the 12 months in this particular year. So it'll start from 0 to 11. So here you are going to print the values from 0 to 11 using this particular variable. That is, I is equal to Jan means you are going to indirectly assign 0 to I. I is less than or equal to December means I is less than or equals to 11, I plus plus, and you are going to print this 11 values. So let's execute these two programs. So first one, you have created a week enumeration and given a value, and if you give Tuesday and execute it, and you are going to get the value as 1. That is, this is 0, this is 1. In the similar manner, if you take the year and I am starting from I is equal to 0, I less than or equals to 11 indirectly. So and I am printing all the values from 0 to 11. So if you see the output in this manner. So we'll see some more things about enumeration. Some interesting facts about enumeration is, the first one is, two enum names can be having same values. That is, here by default you are getting 0 to 11 values, but you can assign values on your own. That is, Jan equal to 0, comma Feb is equal to 1, March is equal to 2, like this you can be assigning values in your enumeration. And two enum names can be having same values. That is, Jan equal to 0, Feb is equal to 0. You can give the values in this manner. But whenever you print, you'll be getting 0, 0, 1, 2, 3 like this. Whatever value you assign, you'll be getting. So two enum VAMs can be having same values. That is, in this particular example, you are going to give two names. That is, failed and freezed equals to 1. Sorry, failed and freezed equal to 0. So if you see the example, enum state working is equal to 1, failed equal to 0, comma freezed equal to 0 you are giving. And if you are printing those values, I am going to get 1, 0, 0. The second one is, you need not explicitly assign values to enum names. The compiler will default give values starting from 0, as you have seen. Will be giving values Monday is equal to 0 until Sunday is equal to 6. By default, you'll be getting these values. And you can assign values to some name in any order. Not that you have to start from 0, you can assign any names. If there is any unassigned, it will take previous value plus 1. For example, in this one, Sunday is equal to 1, you have given assigned a value. By default, Monday will be getting the value 2, Tuesday you are giving as 5, Wednesday by default it will take the value 6, Thursday you are giving 10, Friday will take 11, and Saturday will take 12. And the whatever the value assigned to enums must be in digital constants. That is, whatever the integers you are giving, you have to give only the integers. You cannot give floating point constants or other character constants. So you can be giving values from -36,000 to +36,000. You cannot be giving any value other than that. All the enum constant must be unique in their scope. That is, enum names, not enum constant, enum names must be unique. For example, in this particular example, you are creating two enums, state and result, and you are giving names as working, failed, failed and passed. In these two things, you are giving failed and failed, two enum same names. This will not be working in the program. Why? Because it will be giving you a compilation error, because you have given same name to the enumerations. Okay, so you have to avoid giving same names. Whatever names you are giving enum inside, you have to give unique names. And the last thing about enums is, enums versus macros. We can also use macros to define name constants. So far we have defined like this: hash define working is equal to 0, hash define failed 1, hash define freeze 2. You can have similar like enums, you can have macros in this manner. But enumerations are somewhat advantageous over macros in this manner. Why? Because enums follow scope rules. Whatever I told you in this previous slide, two enums cannot be having same names in the scope. It will be following scope rules, and automatically the enum values will be assigned with, okay, enum names will be assigned values. When you are using macro, you have to specifically give values. But in enumeration, we will be automatically getting the values from 0 to some particular n minus 1. So this is about your type def and enumeration. Type def will be used to give alternative names to your existing data types. Enumeration will be used to create a new data types.